My name is Ryan Abbott. I'm professor of law and health sciences at the University of Surrey School of Law, and my research focuses on regulation of technology, and in particular, regulation of artificial intelligence. One of the areas that I have looked at is regulation of artificial intelligence in the context of intellectual property law. And that's a branch of law that has to do with protecting certain sorts of intangible creations, or what we sometimes call products of the mind. Well, what do you do when you have an artificial intelligence generate what we traditionally think about as a product of the mind? One of the open questions surrounding this is, can that sort of thing even get protection? So if I write a book, I can get copyright protection for that. It lasts 70 years plus the length of my life. But what if I have an AI that generates a new book? And AI has been generating new books for decades. They just haven't been very good. But now they're getting to the point sometimes where some writing by AI is not able to be distinguished from writing by a person. And just as AI is also making new works of literature, making new music, making new films, AI is also active at generating patentable inventions. And there are a lot of underexplored issues associated with whether or not those things could get protection, who would own them, and how they might be infringed. That in turn has a lot of importance for industrial development and using AI in research and development and making sure that using AI allows protection of commercially valuable outputs. So while AI has been doing this for a long time, it's doing it in a more commercially important fashion. And while historically academics have argued AI output doesn't necessarily need the same sorts of protection as human output, I argued, in fact, that it really does. And not because an AI cares whether it's going to get a patent, but because the people who own AI care about getting patents. And so if we provide protection for patentable AI output, this will encourage people to make, use, and develop inventive machines that will generate more innovation for society and ultimately benefit everyone. Now, in addition to working on this academically, I brought together a group of patent attorneys and AI experts to generate two inventions made by an artificial intelligence without a traditional human inventor, and we have filed for patent protection on these in jurisdictions around the world. We're not filing these on the AI's behalf, right? An AI doesn't have legal personality. It wouldn't know what to do with a patent in the first place. We're filing them on behalf of the owner of the AI and arguing that he should be entitled to any protection that subsists in these inventions. We are listing the AI as the inventor, and not again to give it any kind of right, but to inform the public of how the inventions were made and to keep people from claiming credit for work being done by machines. And many jurisdictions around the world didn't have laws governing what to do in this sort of circumstance. And now there is an international debate going on, in part fueled by this case, about whether and to what extent we should be protecting these sorts of things. And there are court cases now going on in the UK and in the US and in Europe over these test cases and about whether or not there should be protection, who or what should be listed as an inventor, and who or what should own any intellectual property rights that come out of these inventions. Not only are these cases continuing, but myself and other members of the research team are participating in these international conversations and helping to shape how the law develops. And this is again a law that not only has impact on businesses like Google and IBM and Pfizer that are using AI for inventing new things, but also on consumers as the end beneficiaries of more innovation and as the end users of products that may go on to have intellectual property protection.